about April, before my exams. I felt like I was dead. You know, I felt so numb on the inside. I felt so numb, but yet I was so insecure. I hated myself. I thought I was ugly. I thought I was a fool. I felt like no one ever wanted to know me. I felt like no one, like, I wasn't worthy of anyone coming to know me. And I felt like, most of all, I felt like I didn't know myself. It was like I was just floating through everything, floating through each day, each moment. And, you know, but more than, and I went, and just to satisfy, to get away from all of this, I resorted to everything possible to just get my mind away from myself, to get my mind to stop thinking. Because in my mind, there was the biggest battle happening that would torment me through each day. It was between the Holy Spirit and my flesh. And it was so bad, like the Holy Spirit was, like, I've never heard God speak to me so audibly, you know, at that point of my life. And it was so loud, like, it was like the Holy Spirit just screaming out to me, telling me what to do, and I would just push him aside and go and do what I wanted to do. And there was one night where I think the battle ended, and I cried out to God in that desperation to just want to be saved, to be changed, because I knew that I had to come back to God. And I just cried out because I knew that it would only be Him that could do this for me, who could save me. And man, I felt God hit me so hard. It was like God's hand just came down upon me, went into my stomach and crushed up all the crap that I was feeding myself and just threw it all out. I curled up on that bed, feeling God's hand go through me and just pull it all out. And I burst out into tears. I've never cried so hard. It was such an intense moment with God. It was like God was right there and His hand was going through me and pulling out all of that. And it was amazing. Like, I've never felt something so tangible as that. And I knew it was God. You know, but in my head, like, I was so high at that moment, like, I was so high that night that I thought that God wouldn't come to me at such a moment, you know, in the depth of my sin. But, you know, God doesn't care what you're in, what situation you're in. He, as long as He sees your heart crying out to Him in desperation, you're His creation, you're His son, the Father will always come and save you. And I opened my Bible on my phone, and I don't know, it was just opened randomly to a scripture, and it was 2 Samuel chapter 22. And you know, God's so funny. He pays attention to the details that you like, you know. And I'm very obsessive about dates, and God gave me 2 Samuel chapter 22. 2 is my birthday, and I was 22 years old at that point, so yeah. And I read it, and it just speaks about, it was so apt for that moment that I was crying out to God, because it speaks about how David was in that moment of desperation, and when his enemies had overwhelmed him, when his enemies were attacking him, and he felt so overwhelmed by all of it, he just cried out to God, and God was his strength, his fortress, his shield. And I felt so amazing, like I knew this was God. And that was my first encounter with God. I always knew I would want to be a pastor, I'd want to join the ministry. And I knew it, like I had this thing planned where I'd be 21, I'd stop everything and I'd get into the ministry, I'd work towards it. But I guess everything was different, you know. I thought I'd build up my testimony to have something to share with people, you know, because every pastor has this great testimony to share. So I thought I'd do that. But, you know, God really revealed this one thing to me where He told me that, why do you want to build up your experience in this world and then talk about how I saved you, but why can't you just build up your experience of me, you know, like experience me, let most of your life be an experience of me. And that was really amazing. It made so much of sense to me, and that was like one of the first revelations that God gave me about Himself. And it was so amazing, like God had a unique plan for me. He didn't want me to be like every other speaker or like any other speaker, but He wanted me to be myself. He wanted me to be Akshay and to have my own testimony of God, to have my own unique individual experience of God. And that's where it all began, you know. Each day I just went back to God's word, I've come from a broken family, so I've a lot of the years of my life I've not had a father. And I was looking at myself in the mirror and it just hit me of how 9 years ago when I came to Bombay, I was in Uncle Willie's house and I would sit in front of that mirror and just sit and cry to myself every day of what had happened with us as a family, and how like my father had separated, how I don't have a father anymore, and how I was going to be fatherless for the rest of my life, and I wouldn't know what it would be like growing up through my most important years, my teenage years, without a father. And it was so amazing how God revealed to me at that moment to how He's been there with me through school, through moments where friends have left me, through college, through moments where I've ran away from Him, ignored Him, completely done, just disobeyed Him, but yet He was there and He pursued me and He loved me through it all. And He was standing there by my side as I slept, as I woke, just calling out to me, and I just ignored Him. But He was so amazing how He provided for each thing. He provided for my college, He provided for school, for every need that I had, God was there. And I really want to thank God, and it's been such an amazing experience to how He showed Himself as how He's been my everlasting Father through it all. And now I feel so complete, like I don't lack having a father, because I know I have a father in God. And as I stood in front of that mirror, looking at myself, it hit me, you know, 9 years back, I was standing in front of a mirror and crying to how I didn't have a father. And now, 9 years down the line, I'm standing in front of a mirror, looking at myself, knowing that I have the most amazing father. And I'd really, really like to thank my mother for being such an amazing mother, to chase after me and to just constantly, it may have been bugging, but I knew that those were the right words that she was saying for that moment that I really needed. And I just like to really thank my mom, because I believe that she's really been given to me by God for such an amazing reason and for such an amazing purpose. My name is Akshay. I found hope. Have you?